Hi all, in this video, let's learn about tree shaking in JavaScript, why it is important, and how to implement it. Let's get started. So firstly, assume your application as a tree, and all the source code and the libraries involved in your application as the leaves of the tree. Fine. So now, all the green leaves, it means living leaves, used code are considered as the green leaves, and unused code, let's assume that as a brown leaves. It means dead code, dead leaves. In order to get rid of the dead leaves, like brown leaves, you need to shake the tree, okay, causing them to fall. So this is what the tree shaking process we do in the application. Okay, so now how to do that and why we need to do the tree shaking? Because tree shaking is very much important in order to optimize our web application. The production build should be very light enough so that it can be processed, downloaded, and executed very fast. So in order to have the optimization of the web application, we'll be using this tree shaking technique. So this is the reason why we are going to use the tree shaking and how the tree shaking would work. So tree shaking will work based upon the ES6 import and exports, because the static moduling will help that tree shaking. And I will explain more about this, how it works with an example. So now, before starting this, I recommend you to see this getting started with the webpack so that the webpack configuration basic setup you can have. Okay, now let's get started. So firstly, let's see the webpack configuration. So we are in the mode of development, and the optimization technique we are used is used exports true. So now what we are going to do is math.js file. So there is a function, there's a file in this. We have two functions. One is square, one is cube. Both we are exporting, and in main file we are only using cube function, not square, only we are using cube function. But now when you bundle, so let me bundle it. So if you bundle it, what happens in the bundle file? So the bundle.js file, here you can see both the files included. The in the math you have square and the cube, but only you are using cube. Okay, now this cube you can consider as a green leaf. This is a green leaf. And the square you're not using. This can be considered as a brown leaf. It means a dead leaf. Unused code. You can also call it as an unused code. So you're using this. It is fine. It should be included in the build. You're not using this. It should not be included in the build. But if you see in the bundle.js file, if you check for the, let me check for the unused, you can find it. So you can see the unused imports here. So in the comment, see, you can see unused harmony export square. So it is stating that this function is unused. Okay? Even if it is used or not used, it is being included in the bundle.js file, which is not correct. Okay. Now we need to shake the application. Like we need to do tree shaking technique once so that this unused imports, unused, all unused, will be unused code would be eliminated. Fine. This is what we have wanted to do. So to do so, what we can do is go to the webpack config and comment out this mode development and optimization and keep this as a production. Okay. Now let me run this once again. So let me remove this bundle.js and let me run the build once again. So if I run the build once again, what happens? See here, it is again optimized code was came in the build.js. Now here you can't see the square function because it is not included in the production build. So with the help of this webpack mode production, so this tree shaking can be applied. Okay, but if you don't want to go to the production mode, okay, and even you want this webpack, like even if you don't want to go to the production mode and wanted to have this tree shaking technique, then you need to use one plugin. That plugin is known as module concatenation plugin. So this is what you need to use in the webpack. If you go there into the production mode, this would be automatically used. If you are in a development mode and wanted to use a tree shaking technique, then this is the plugin you need to use in the webpack. So now I hope you understand what is the tree shaking and how to implement that tree shaking and how to remove the dead code. Now let's understand why it only works for the ES6 imports and exports. For example, let me go to this place. So for example, this is a common JS module, common module JS. So this is not ES6 modules like imports and exports. This is a common module JS file. So here what happens is, it will, based upon this condition, it would import neither cube or the square. One of this would be imported, not both. Okay. Now this is based upon this condition, and this is a at the runtime. It will happen at the runtime, and this, in this approach, tree shaking will not be processed. Tree shaking can't decide which module should be imported, which module is importing, which module is exporting. Okay, at the runtime, this happens at the runtime. So tree shaking can't be applied here. Okay, excluding these files at the build time will not be practical for the tree shaking. So it will not work for this common JS modules. It will only work for the ES6 modules. The reason behind this is, in the ES6, imports and exports are static importing. Everything would be like a static importing, imports. In sense, all the files would be at the top. All the files should be imported globally at the top. See, all the imports will be at the top. It means we are telling that this file needs all these imports, the dependencies like this. So this is mean by the static importing, which means all the files will be imported globally at the top. With this, only tree shaking can work. So tree shaking will work efficiently in this order, because it can clearly understand what is dependent upon what, and it can make the right decisions to remove the unused exports depending upon this. So that is the reason it will not work for this common module JS. It will only work for the ES6 imports and exports. Tree shaking relies on ES6 imports and exports. Actually, this concept was popularized on rollup. Rollup is also similar like Webpack module bundler. Based upon that, this was came into picture. So one more concept wanted to discuss while we are discussing about this tree shaking is a side effect. Okay, side effects also needs to be understood and discussed while we are working with the tree shaking. Okay, let's firstly understand what is a side effect. For example, there is a function. This is a function, add number. This add number function has a side effect. How I can say that? Because it is modifying one variable. See, it is modifying these numbers. Okay, inside this function, it means it is modifying something which is not in its scope, which is out of its scope. It means this function has some side effect. Okay. The main problem with the side effects is, so tree shaking, while you're doing tree shaking, it's like you need to understand which piece of code you need to remove. Okay. If you have side effects like this, okay, tree shaking will face issues. It can't make a decision which code will be used or which code can't be used. Okay. For example, the another best example is the polyfills. So in the polyfills, what happens is, we are not sure when and where the polyfills will be used. So thus we can't take a decision to remove or to keep some code. So these type of or polyfills, all these are known as a side effects. Okay. Now, how to understand or how to take the side effects with the Webpack tree shaking. So for example, here in the package.json file, if you think in your application, there is no side effect, everything is straightforward, everything is a pure functions. Okay. Then you can go here and you can mention the side effects as false. It means your application is, sorry, you can mention this as a false. It means your application is free from side effects if you mention this. Okay. If you feel that there are some like polyfills, I told you, right? The polyfills has high chances of the side effects because we don't know what piece of code and where it would be used, the polyfills. In these cases, you can give a hint to the Webpack stating that this polyfills.js file. So this is of side effects. It means this file consists of the side effect. So in this way, the tree shaking method, tree shaking technique would be work in an optimized way, and it can take the right decisions whether to remove the code or not based upon mentioning the side effects. So S should be there, side effects. Okay. This is what about side effects. So we have understand what is a tree shaking, how the name got, and what is its importance, and how to implement it, and what is all about the side effects, and why the tree shaking can't be implemented to this common module JS, because these decisions are made at the runtime. Okay, but to bundle, to remove the code at the build time, it is not practical to remove some code. So that's the reason tree shaking works for the ESX modules, not for the common module JS. Fine. So this is all about the tree shaking in JavaScript. Hope you understand the video. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe for more videos. Thank you.